Hello, how are you? Now again with the verbs, and in verbs, modal auxiliaries. So parts of speech, we went to noun, then pronoun, conjunction, preposition, and now. You all might be thinking that sir is repeating the same thing again and again and again. But it is to know you all. For just you can say you can remind that we are going through English, and that also most important portion is grammatical portion. As you have seen, you might we have seen yeah going through 10 standard papers. You will see most probably section C, D, and E. They belong to grammatical section. I think so it might be more than 60-70% of the weightage regarding grammar section. Why government has designed such a thing? To improve your English as you are an Englishman. So now name of person, place of thing, then pronoun, the name which is used instead of noun, conjunction joining two words, two sentence, two phrase, two clause. Is it so? Preposition. Somewhat it joins, yeah, it does, it's add something in verb, yeah, what? Noun, I think it's modify also, we can say. Just like adjective also, then we add something in noun and pronoun. But here, sir, it suggests the work of noun and pronoun. Then we went to verbs. The most important thing regarding the sentences, yeah, English language, we can say, that is verb. In that transitive verb, intransitive verb, and most probably the usage of modal auxiliary verbs, we can say. In that we got may, might, could, would, I think so. The pronunciation also I took. Then we are moving with some modal auxiliary verbs that are useful to us. Let us see. Number one is should. S like would, yeah, would, it's would, should also is that. It is used for advice, for duty, for moral obligation, for instruction. See, these rules are important and not important. Just you understand regarding these rules, that advice is there. So while giving advice, you are in confusion, what to use? You would do this, you could do this, you should do this. Once you will practice these all things in your daily life, obviously it will come. You yourself will understand what will come. Either would will come, should will come, could will come, may will come, might will come. New words are there with on the boards also. Let us see. So for advice, for duty also, we used to use should, moral obligations, it is that. To say something that it's your moral, it's duty, some moral duties are there. Then comes instruction. To give a particular instruction, we are using should. Let us go with an example. You should see a doctor at once. What does it stand for? It's for duty. It's for moral obligation. Yeah, it's for instruction. Obviously, it's instruction. You should see a doctor at once. It's an instruction. Instruct karte hain with this sentence. Then comes, we should stand united. We should stand united. Not United States of America. We should stand united. What does it suggest? Can I write, we would stand united, we could stand united, yeah, we should stand united. You listen this three sentence properly. What do you get? Easily you know English. English is there in you all, and lots of grammar is there. As you are studying it from 9 year, 10 year, 12 year, 7 year, whatever it may be. But you got English because you got your mother tongue also properly. You know that you have English in you. You got English in you. There are lots and lots of words that is hidden in your heart, in your mind too. But the particular way how to express is this. I am just polishing you. I am not teaching. I am just polishing you to improve something, to take out your words from your heart, from your mind. So we can easily say, we should stand united. What does it suggest? It suggests advice. It's our duty. It's a moral obligation. Yeah, it's instruction. It's not duty, it's compulsory. No, it's not duty, but it's a moral obligation. Morally, if we think regarding to our morals, we say, can say we should stand united. If we are united, nobody can defeat us. So let us go now to the next one, must. I think so you all might have understood about should. It comes in advice, it comes in duty, it comes in moral obligations, and also in instructions. Now we are moving to the another word, that is must. What does must suggest? You must read this. Is it? You must read it. There is necessity. There is necessity and obligation too. With these two main things, must is going on. How to use must? When to use must? Let's go with one example. You must save money for old age. What does it suggest? You have to save your money for your old age, so that your children, your grandchildren don't kick you out. So you must save money for old age. What does it suggest? It suggests necessity. It suggests because it's needed. It's necessary. So it suggests necessity. Then comes, you must pay your fees before to stay. It's obligation. You must pay. Bharni hi pade. You must pay your fees before Tuesday. So it's obligation, it's necessity. Can you say this sentence is necessity? You can transform this sentence into necessity needs, we can see. But it's obligation. You must not come here again. So you could come again, you could not come again, you should not come again, you would not come again. Whenever a word is typically written over, yeah, spoken over, it obviously, but a sentence is because spoken over, yeah, written over, it obviously it gives meaning, it shares something, it fills something in our mind. Whenever you go with the word, yeah, with the sentence, yeah, with the paragraph, yeah, whatever it is, you don't know, you are going the first time, then also it suggests our mind, you know, it's more, it's working more than computer. Because man has made computer. Computer ne insaan nahi banaya. It's more powerful than computer. But to use it, it's up to you all, even to me. So you must not come here again. Is it necessity? It's also, it's one type of order, it's one type of obligation, we can say. You must not come here again. You should not come here again. Does it settle over? Because what is there in should? It's advice, duty, moral obligation, yeah, instruction. This is not instruction. This is one type of order. You must not come here again. Understand it. So we are making some little bit typical mistakes regarding our languages. So verbs are important. So you have to go again. Now what is the past tense of must? Everything I told before starting verb, yes, so Did you have to write 100 V1, V2, V3? I got only 3 students. I think so they are from 10th standard year, so one is Kavya, I forgot another name, but it's needed. I need this thing. I am waiting for you. How many students are just going through my videos? How many are accepting it? How many are needy for English? And how many are brilliant? Some are more brilliant. Yeah, some are genius. Those who don't go through the videos also. But due to certain condition of COVID-19, we have to face this problem. And I have to go, yeah, our management have to go through these videos. Otherwise, we all might be in a good mood in class. So let us be. What is the past tense of must? We have, this is a formula, had plus 2. I know nobody, some might remember this thing. But automatically it generates from your heart. It will generate from your mind. So let us have example. The candidates had to appear for an interview after the written test. So we cannot write the candidate must appear, because it is a past tense of must. The candidates had to appear. Had to is the past form of must. Past tense of must, we also can say, appear for an interview after the written test. Got it properly? If we will go with must over here, so listen it properly. The candidate must appear for an interview after the written test. In that, these all candidates, I am also one candidate. But after test, my mood changes. As you all have changing your mood, particularly at particular time. Some are serious in studies, some are just giving their 100% in class with attention in class, and some are in tension. Some give, some pays attention, and some are in tension too. Though some are there, those who think what will happen in examination, yeah, what will happen after I will go at home, I will meet my friend or not, I will get Activa or not, I will get mobile or not. But you know, you got already mobile, your parents are saying go through your work with mobiles. Even me too. I used to give my mobile to my daughters. Take beta, sit over there and prepare something, learn something. So you, whatever you want, God has gifted you. You need mobile phone, smartphone with you. First of all, parents used to deny. Now parents are going, please go through your mobile and study. Some are playing games. Recently, my colleague called me yesterday. Some are, maximum students are playing games. They are not interested in these online studies. Only few, we can say only a few. A little few, we can say. Can we say little few? Few of my students are interested, particularly apart from mathematics and science. So, when you read this sentence, the candidates must appear for an interview after the written examination. So its necessity is that he must, nahin, appear karna hi hai. A candidate is like me. I don't want to appear. So here we are using the past tense form of must. And that is had to appear. They had to appear. 60, 100 candidates are, if one or two don't want to appear, it's up to them. But they had to appear. What an idea, different between must and past tense of must. Here, if you will read must properly with once, twice, thrice, four times, five times, and then you will go through had to, you automatically it will come in your mind what is the real form. It's had to is proper, yeah, must is it in proper form. You will definitely you will get the idea. Listen it properly, listen the pronunciation of each and every teacher, how they pronounce the word, how they express their expression. You know, without you all we cannot give our 100% also, but we think that we can give you more and more. No doubt you and we and I and all, we all are in larger year long distance. Don't know when we will meet. We will come face to face. Face to face teaching is very good, you can get the idea properly, but due to circumstance certain, we can say we are far away from each other. So be with your teacher. It's for about 20-25 minutes. You can easily spend these all things. In spite of being 6-7 hours in classes in school, no doubt that life, as I told, is a very, very, very precious life, school life. But this is also a diamond you get from your teacher. So let's go further without talking. Let's have need. You all need everything. You need a very good car, Ferrari, yeah, many, many things, Mercedes, yeah. Many cars you need. You need sport bikes. Girls are fond of many, many things. So need. Everywhere there is a need. To survive, we need something. To be here, we need something. So how we will use this need in our needs? Go through my sentence. How we will use this need in our needs? Can you get the idea a little bit? Here again, how we will go with this need for our needs? Let's go. We need a lot of money for the wedding. It works with a verb. It works with the modal auxiliary verb also. Need jo hai na, it works with verb. Also, it works with modal auxiliary verb. We need a lot of money for the wedding. We need money. So here it is used as verb. And now it is used as modal auxiliary. How? Need I come again? No, you needn't. And here my dear friends will say, sir, why need? Why not do I come again? Can I come again? Can as a modal auxiliary you can use. Can I come again? Could I come again? Should I come again? Then can you, cannot will be the answer. Should you? No, you shouldn't will be the answer. No, you wouldn't will be the answer. See, I have written question and answer both thing over here. This is a particular question and this is particular answer. I have written both the things. Imagine instead of need, you are writing should. Should I come again? As a verb, you can use should. As a verb, you can use would. As a verb, you can use could. But in answer, in modal auxiliary form, writing the answer, you will write no, you shouldn't. No, you wouldn't. No, you couldn't. So here need I come again? Zaruriyat hai. Meri zarurat hai. No. You need it. The particular form need is used. Understand it. we were writing was and could and can and many many things. May I come again? No, you may needn't. I can't get answer. No, you mayn't, you will write. Can't you write? So this is the right answer. No, you needn't. Now what is the past form of this thing? Past tense form, we can say. We are using need plus have. Let's go. Need he have taken all that trouble? Need he have taken all that troubles? We can write do. Do he have taken? Does he have taken all that troubles? But we are using need. So need he have taken all that troubles is there. Now we are going to another section. Ought. Ought. It comes many times in spoken language. Let us see. Ought comes for advice, reason, moral values, duties. Let us go with example. You ought to read this book. It is very interesting. So it gives reason. Why you are reading? You ought to read. Yes, you have to read. Another form is because it is very interesting. Now, people ought not to take or offer bribes. People ne ought liya. Ought. O-U-G-H-T. Ought. People ought kasamli, we can say, one type of. Not to take or offer bribes. Now comes past tense of ought. Ought plus to plus have we are using. Let us. The driver ought to have been more careful. The driver, here what is? It is his duty. It suggests his duty. The driver ought to have been more careful. What does it mean? This has the meaning that the driver was not careful. It was the duty of the driver. When we are driving, it is the duty of a driver to be careful. Here what is? The driver ought to have been more careful. The sentence suggests something. He ought to have usko uski duty ke prati careful rehna. That is, what does it suggest? The driver was not careful. It means that he was not careful. Ought, obviously, in English language, it is been used sometimes, but it suggests a very good example of language. When you use ought, it suggests your impression also. I ought to be a good to everybody. We can say like this. So this modal auxiliaries are there. These all are useful in your daily routine, whatever you all are writing. Practice it. It works properly. Whatever I have written, whatever I taught you, please try to practice more and more for your future. Thank you.